Senior house officers were undergoing specialized training to become general orthopedics, surgeons, pediatricians, cardiologists, oncologists, gynecologists, among others, have laid down tools over the accumulated allowance arrears. Speaking to journalists today in Kampala, they said that while they were entitled to a 2.5 million monthly allowance, they haven't been paid for the past 4 to 6 months, which has made their daily life very difficult.
Officers resolved to reactivate their suspended strength and laid down tools at the General Assembly held this week on Wednesday, 26th of April, 2023, effective Labor Day at midnight. So today, when it clocks 000 hours, senior house officers are going to step off the wards. As responsible doctors and people who love our patients and our country, we are aware that most Ugandans who seek our service are vulnerable, including the poor. As such, we maintain our ethical obligation to provide emergency cover during this strike. However, in the next 1 week, if the government does not respond, we will have no choice but withdraw totally.
Then we are suffering in the hospitals as a result of not having the cadres on this table here. So what is the fact? 64% of deaths occur in three levels: general hospitals, general referral hospitals, national referral hospitals. And that is where these three cadres actually serve.
The resolution to pay senior house officers a monthly allowance was decided in 2016 when President Yoweri Museveni, while attending the Uganda Medical Association General Assembly, said that not paying these graduate doctors was an act of modern slavery. The president directed that their payments be made effective 1st July 2021, something that has not yet been fully embraced. Their payments are often so much on and off. These specialists are perturbed by the failure by the Ministry of Finance to allocate the 80.5 billion shillings to cater for medical interns in the next financial year. During this press conference, the pre-intern doctors also demanded to be deployed.
All senior house officers from year one onwards must be paid their allowances. Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Health should work together and find this money. It is not a lot of money. They should find this money. If they can give it to individuals, they can find it for doctors who are serving Ugandans. You recently saw a tweet from Professor Idro, our immediate past president of Uganda Medical Association, who was in Jinja, a ward of, I think, 200, supposed to take on 200 children, had 450, with three pediatricians.
His Excellency, if you're there listening or watching this, you told your bazukulu to do science courses. Well, the bazukulu are old now, and they've done these science courses. The bazukulu are now doctors, nurses, and midwives. But you can imagine they've been seated at home for almost a year because Ministry of Health and Ministry of Finance say they don't have money. Remember, you gave a directive to them on how these medical interns should be paid. But they seem to know more than you by overturning the directive you gave to them in 2021.
The recent survey by the Uganda Medical Association indicated that public hospitals in the country are faced with a 60% of human resource gap. It's even worse for the specialists. The gap stands at 70%. With this gap, it's evident that the government mostly depends on the senior house officers. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuaya for the news.